Hello everybody, welcome back to the Binding of Isaac Afterbirth. We're going to do another Eve run today because I disappointed myself in the last episode. That's a pretty good start though. We're going to end up going into Horde Babylon right here, not taking another hit of damage because it'll kill us, and then taking the pentagram and walking straight out. Kaylee's playing some Undertale, I can see that. Good on you, Kaylee. But we are playing some Binding of Isaac Afterbirth. How's everybody doing? It's a beautiful Sunday in the neighborhood, and I am your host, John Scott, who is some imaginary man I just made up. This room was not real welcome by me, let me tell you. We got our item room. Whoa, what's going on with Eve? We're already in Horde Babylon, talked about that a little bit, and we... There's one more person? Hello? Hi, how are you? We want to get into a permanent Horde Babylon state by taking a deal with the devil. That will then allow us to get into that permanent Horde Babylon state. We also want to get a luck upgrade from that, which is totally fine. We also want to try to get to Mega Satan on this run, so however we can go about doing that would be acceptable in my book. It'll probably be in the way of a self-sacrifice room if we are trying to get a deal with the devil to provide us with forever Horde Babylon state, but obviously we will see what happens in the long run. We could start out with a Krampus fight, and then we have no chance of getting that deal with the devil, and instead we get angel deals. I don't know. I'm rambling a little bit. So let's fight our first boss. We're sitting on half a heart, which should be fair. A little bit sketchy, but I live on the edge. What can I say? Pepsi bottle. Coca-Cola. Or wait, I screwed that up. Wow. Pepsi glass. Wait. I'm gonna have to go watch that now. Everybody knows what I'm talking about. That one kid that has a Pepsi glass or a Coke glass and then puts the other preferred cola. Pepsi's so bad, okay? I absolutely despise it. Coke all the way. Pepsi tastes like medicine and it burns as it's going down your throat. And that is totally unacceptable in my books. This is a case where we don't take breakfast just because we're trying to get rid of HP, not get HP, a little silly goose. So let's not take that. But Pepsi's just like, if I'm going to have a nice cold soda pop, or where I come from, a nice pop, because apparently only Northern Ohio calls it pop, and, you know, the rest of the world calls it soda, or soda pop, who is also my favorite character from the great book, The Outsiders. But Holy Light, okay. Not an item we get all the time, so I like it. But if I'm gonna have a nice cold pop, give me Coke and then put it in a nice tall glass with some ice. That sounds beautiful to me. Or give me a ice cold Dr. Pepper. In the summer, give me a Sprite and then put some, like, you know, the little glasses of maraschino cherries. Give me those. And then put one into the Sprite. Give me a nice Shirley Temple. That's how I like to have my Sprite. A lot of you may disagree. That's alright. You're entitled to your opinion. I'm entitled to mine. Let's just keep this Are You a Wizard going forever, apparently. Do we risk cracking into a chest to get a bomb? What just happened? Hello? Okay, we're good. I'm gonna crack into the chest. Pray we get a bomb from it. We got more bombs from it. Life is really, really good. We then crack into this. We get small rock. Two spirit hearts. Also acceptable. And then we come up here, we crack into this, and from there, we're going to get a pill, which is a Balls of Steel. HP off the charts right now. Do you see me being upset about that? Because I'm not. Okay, Holy Light, totally amazing right now. Is it just like, did it get nerfed? Or anti-nerfed? Did it get better? Boosted? Amplified? Risen? I don't know what word you want to use there. Because it's, like, really good right now. We also did get a luck upgrade, so that's helping out a bit. What if you could get a high enough luck upgrade that's just a holy shot, holy light shots, everybody? What if you got one every single time you fired? That would be insanely good damage. Look how fast we killed him! Damage is insane. Okay, evil up and a shot speed up is great. And then we're going to totally take both of these. Because they're both great. Dark Bomb allows us to have the chance of getting a nice set of Spirit Hearts every once in a while. And Guppy's Tail is going to provide us with a bunch of Golden Chests. and more HP is fine. We can actually debate about playing a self-sacrifice room on this floor if we find it. Because we are getting hella HP. And that's great. This run is looking to be quite phenomenal. Although last run was looking to be quite phenomenal. Hematemesis, you go, girl. You give me all the spirit hearts. Glen Coco, you can go. Okay. We're going to absolutely go in here just because it has the opportunity to provide us with some guppy items. And we are going to play this guy as well just because he can pop out something we don't want. Excellent. Relax. Relax and take a crap everywhere. That's my motto for life. Okay, that was a bit of a bust, but you can't win them all. Some games you're just going to lose. The 95 Bulls were phenomenal, and they still lost 10 games. The 2015 Golden State Warriors are pretty trash, but they broke the record. Let's not talk about that. Okay, sure, Pinky Eye. That'll provide us with zero benefit 99% of the time. But we'll take it anyway. Do we want to attempt to get that out? I'm going to say yeah. You know what? Screw it. That's how I feel about that. That provided us with a good bit of stuff. And you know what? We're going to place a bomb, throw it in, and that's going to... Okay, you know what? Good enough. That was probably a big waste of HP, time, energy, money, intellectual ability, and it probably gave somebody AIDS as well, so it's not the best. Okay, walking host. Screw off, thank you. HP now a little bit lower due to my own personal stupidity. I recognize that, and I will play better in the future, don't you worry. That was like three Holy Light shots in a row. The luck is insane right now. Give me more luck upgrades. I want to see all of them. We're also making really good time right now. I would also love to get a hangman or just any way of flying. Excellent. Sad Onion. Really good. It's a DPS in my book. Okay. This is like a really good run. We just want to accomplish everything that we said, which includes the old Mega Satan little portion that I am choosing to ignore a bit and wasting a lot of HP. Sackboy, that is also really good. So let's try to get that. Okay, we will find a coin somewhere that we can steal and head back. There's our coin, and we will go and grab Sackboy. Excellent. That's going to drop a sack now, and that sack is going to give us a key and a bomb. Excellent. Okay, we're on our boss. Our boss should be pretty easy, unless it's the dark one. Oh, hey, it's the dark one. I'll be damned. No, this shouldn't be that hard. Just land a couple of Holy Light shots. Okay, nice brimstone. I appreciated that. Kind of forgot you had one, so that's good. Okay, don't run. Thank you. We got a deal, which is excellent, and that deal includes... Okay, we can get hella consumables if we take... Oh my... Boy, okay. Here's what we do. We take... Guppy. Then we take... Little Brim. Then we take Contract from Below. Okay, and we're still in Horror Babylon State. We now have some extra little dudes with us. Contract from Below is just going to give us a ton of sacks. Consumables we won't have to worry about for the rest of this run. And to be fair, with consumables comes great drops like Hierophant cards and chests, which give us a bunch of good stuff. Do we want to rock Tammy's head? It's a real interesting one. Are we going to reroll this run? Man, I really don't want to, but we might. We'll see what happens. Five room. It's going to redo this floor. Let's first go... I think we will totally redo this floor, but let's find our item room first to get the most out of said reroll. And honestly, we might find our boss too and get a second deal with the devil. Just amp up the damage here. Okay, there's our item room. Which is... Oh my god, okay. I totally forgot we had 9 lives for a second there, and that scared the absolute poop out of me. So that's good. Retrovision is not good. It gave us an AWAS rune. Okay, we place it down. Gave us a ticket to the next floor. We now have a way to redo the floor. We have a way to skip the floor. We have homing shots, which is pretty sick, nasty, awesome. We have a fool card. We have a lover's card, which is more spirit hearts. Excellent. We do want to still find our boss. Do we? I actually think that is the best course of action. Let's find our boss. Let's get the most out of this 5 room. And just go buck wild on this old day here. Okay, excellent. 2 of spades, double everything. Let's actually attempt to get more. Okay, we are getting a little bit precarious here. Okay, really? Just knock those out. I want to really get all of that stuff. Magician. Okay, we'll call it a day on that old fun time I just did right there. What an odd run this is right now. There's a lot of weird things going on. I just realized that Head of the Keeper Sackboy is an insanely good synergy, and also homing shots with Holy Light is also an insanely good synergy. So we got, like, everything going well for us right now. We just need to not be stupid and have stuff like that happen. Okay. Slow your roll, Ty. You are okay. Excellent. We just want to find our boss. I don't really care about the shop, even though I actually do really care about the shop. 2 of diamonds, okay. Sun card. That allows us to see where we're going, and we are going indeed the right way. We'll probably pop 2 of diamonds in this shop right here and just take everything. This would be a good time for chaos. We'll take piggy bank. We'll take the spirit heart. I see no reason to take sharp plug if we don't have the D6. If we have the D6, sharp plug is okay. Strength we'll just use on this boss. I do realize that this probably hinders our chance of a boss rush situation, but I think that it's actually totally worth it. We also might not get a deal here. I just realized that. We've taken a lot of red heart damage. So this is a lucky one if we get it. We didn't, but we got torn photo, and that is, in all honesty, worth our time here. So that's good. We can then redo this floor, get another good item room, get another boss, and honestly, just another chance at a deal with the devil, which is pretty worth it. We're going to stick with Razor Blade for right now, because Tammy's Head can be pretty boring, so let's not do Tammy's Head. I feel like I do Tammy's Head a lot, so let's not do it. We can see our health this time, which is nice. One singular red heart's pretty bad. I could go for a tiny bit more damage and not having to rely on Holy Light shots. But, I mean, that's just, like, me complaining. We're kind of really set on this run. I just need to not play bad, and then we're good. Okay, excellent. Pop into this. Nothing too special. Pop into this. Nothing too special. Spirit hearts, totally acceptable. Still wanting to hit a self-sacrifice room, so as soon as we can get a buttload of HP, life will be great for us. And that's all you, Dark Bum. Let's get an insanely good synergy like Bloody Penny and just go buck wild here. We're gonna get enough consumables that we should pop every golden chest we get. Hangman. The Sun, okay. We do have a self-sacrifice room, that is good to know. I like the thought of the fact that we got 9 lives and can use our lives here to... Okay, come on. Come on. We can use our lives to get plays in the self-sacrifice room, but I also realize that that's probably a bad idea. Temperance card is kind of useless. 2 of hearts is also kind of useless. Monstro's tooth is really useless. Well, what do we want to do here? We want to hit our shop, that's for sure. We also want to find a way to get as many red hearts as possible, just because we want Dark Bum to pay out with a bunch of spirit hearts. Okay. Good, what's in here? I knew a greed fight was coming. this could give us a actually buttload of consumables. Instead, it gave us not really all that many. So that's fine. What is this? Hangman again. I actually, you know what? This is a unique one. I just realized the Temperance could give us, it could give us sacks. So let's just blow it up, because that's going to give us, okay, no sacks. Gave us a black heart, okay? We can't really do a whole lot with the self-sacrifice room, I recognize that. We can head in here, blow up all of the things in the arcade, get sacks off of that, hopefully get more red hearts off of that. And actually, we're going to play this, because we want a better trinket, and we want a bunch of spirit hearts. I thought our luck stat was good. Am I making a liar on myself right now? Okay. Callus is better than Pinkie Eye. It's not great, though. Come on, payout. Credit card is pretty good. Probably carry that around with us. I'm fine spending a lot of money because we're going to get a ton of money in return. Okay, really just a couple of spirit hearts. Thank you. Keep them coming. Okay. Give me... Okay, I love all the runes. Algiz, Bracano, Hierophant, Magician, Hierophant, Emperor, okay. Emperor's good. Let's go fly a kite. Let's go, we'll carry credit card. Let's head and go, like, start fighting our boss. And then we'll head back to the self-sacrifice room, and I think it's acceptable to play it. Okay, I was actually kind of hoping that would blow him up, but we're fine. I don't really want to play him, only because he... Yeah, we kind of want to go get that. He can give us HP, and I don't think it's really, like, worth it to go for some other item. Okay, Golden Bombs is excellent. More Spirit Hearts is excellent. Two of Spades is excellent. There's Credit Card again. Strength is okay. I want Credit Card, though, for a deal with the Devil, which we should get here. Okay, there's the stain. Just get some holy light shots in. Please. Please. Okay, you're almost dead. There we go. Pass fire, no deal with the devil. Alright. We'll go play the self-sacrifice room. We should be able to, if we get lucky, get at least one key piece. I think we should be able to get all. Oh, we have Callus. Okay. That scared me for a second. We should be able to get all of them, to be honest. Oh, we can't play that while we have the Callus. Good to know. Okay. This is also going to drop sacks, which could give us good stuff. Okay. I will kill myself as well here. Although, that won't work because it's going to teleport us out of the room when we die, and then it'll like lose the angels. But if we keep dropping spirit hearts, then we're totally fine. There's the first angel. Excellent. Don't die. Okay, we're good. First angel is dead. First key piece is sitting there. Key piece one. Okay, now we need to find a way to generate a spirit heart. Because we only need one more hit, and that'll give us a second key piece. So... Dark Bum, help me find some red hearts. Hangman. Red hearts, or just a spirit heart drop. Red hearts or spirit hearts, come on. Secret room? No secret room. Come on. You should drop a red heart, actually. Infinite... Okay, we now have infinite bombs, infinite keys, double chests, well, Cricket's head is nice. I suppose Tammy's head is just begging for us to take it now, so we'll take it. Actually, no, we're not. We're gonna stick with Razorblade. I owe it to Razorblade. Where is our secret room? Our secret room is right here, probably. We're taking a lot of time. I know. I hear all of your complaints in the back of my head. I get that. Come on. Just give me a freaking red heart! Okay, this is a good opportunity. Crack die. What do we do with crack die? What was our shop? Our shop was greed. I know that when we die, it's just going to teleport. Okay, that was good. It's just going to teleport us out. We won't be able to fight the angel. So we can't do that. Come on. Where is Super Secret Room? Super Secret Room is in here. And it's a ton of red. Thank you, everybody. This has been a glorious time. I'd like to thank my sponsors, Ticonderoga Pencils, number 2 and number 3. Oh, no, Dark Bum. Dark Bum, no. Dark Bum, no. Dark Bum, no. Okay. Thank you. Excellent. Let's go fight our angel. And then we can finally get off of this floor. We're going to be way behind schedule. Would you stop taking hits? I really hope it's... I'm pretty sure it's just one after another. But... Oh, you got to be kidding me. Please, 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 please. Okay. No, you little screwbag. Okay, we can use crack die to generate... Oh, actually, pop the strength card. And then get rid of Callus. Get rid of Callus. I was hitting Q. There's our angel. I love it. Oh, just kill him. Just kill him. Oh, my lord. Okay. We good. We can fight Mega Satan now. Excellent. I love it. This is a weird episode, man. Okay. Let's carry... What was this? AWAS. Let's carry Crack Die with us and then head down. Cool. I like it. Now we can start getting back onto track here. Boss Rush Dreams are already dead, and we're 2 floors behind, which is not the best. But we do have our key pieces, and we have a really good run, so we should be able to still win this. It's just going to take a little longer. And the commentary's been pretty slow in that area, so that's fine. Excellent. I love that. You know what? Screw that room. No reason for me to even want to go back into that. Okay, back on normal commentary. We got a item room to find. We have 2 chests to open. We have that to pop, 2 of spades. Okay, there's our item room, which is going to give us something incredible we love. Blood rites. That is not something incredible we love. Okay, I kind of just want to, like, sprint through the rest of this floor and just go. Another self-sacrifice room, funny joke. Okay. Probably not using Little Brim as much as I should, too. We're good. Key for a key, eye for an eye, penny for a penny. I'll take all those. Bombs are key is... do we really have that many, keys? Wait, what? I'm very confused. But it's fine. I'm always confused. Makes no difference. Okay. Shiny rock is good in the fact that it allows us to see crawl spaces, so let's do it. We will also not take the hermit and stick with dice shard. We can use dice shard on our item room. Let's actually go do that. And it gave us mom's knife. Okay, cool. That's now a super one run. And it's homing mom's knife, which is quite strange, but I also love it. Okay. Yeah, this is pretty good. It's good and it's bad, because it's like, it's homing, that's for sure. But it's also like, I'm trying to get it at one place and it's not going where I want it to go. It's very weird. Okay. Crack into more. The Sackboy is so insanely overpowered. Judgment. It's a demon judgment. I don't even got time for you, bro. Child's Leash is not good. Tower's not good. I'm probably leaving behind all kinds of good cards and crap, but I don't really care. This run is one to an extent. Car Battery, excellent. Mom's Purse, excellent. Spirit Heart, excellent. Secret Rock, that I totally would have missed if it wasn't for the stupid thing, so I shouldn't trash talk it. And then, is this our way to all of our stuff? I'm gonna go yeah. Dark Bomb, keep grinding. Probably should have let him pick up that last one there, but that's fine. Okay. The double chest drops from Contract from Below are pretty good. The Devil card we'll just use on our boss. Pick up the Spirit Heart Dark Bomb dropped. Okay. The cage, the damage is really good. All we gotta do is just survive, and we won this run. Cat of Nine Tails is good. Sure, we'll take Death's Touch, and sure, we'll take Dark Matter. That'll kill us, but what do I care? The damage is still off the charts amazing. Even more so now. Yeah, this run is pretty okay. It's kind of weird, but it's pretty okay. We should be able to just steam run the rest of this. And I really have no need to pick up consumables either. So let's just steamroll our way through the run. Sure, we'll pick up more options for one floor. That seems acceptable. And you know what? We should go back and at least see our item room. Something like Polyphemus would just add to this run. So let's go grab that. Okay. Battery charges out the wazoo. I would love to get, in all honesty, a better spacebar item now. Yeah, sure. The homing mom's knife that just tends to, like, stay on them and just pour in the damage is so good. Okay. A better trinket would also be great. We now got 99 everything. For anybody watching this and was like, oh, he's, it's a 40-minute run. He must have had a really tough time. They're gonna be quite confused watching this. Okay, what we got in our item room? Sure, and all stats up. And then pop the razor blade, go back into Horror of Babylon. Even though our damage is, like, off the charts amazing anyway. And then we moon. And we get some more money, which means more sacks, which means a Two of Hearts card, which means we pop it, and then Razor Blade, just for fun. And then, you know, another sack, which gives us another card, which is a Chariot card, which is kind of useless. Okay. I don't even got anything, like, weird to say. Any weird comments about this run. It's just really good. Yeah. Okay, we're going to the negative. We get a deal. That deal gives us another Guppy item, which does make us Guppy now. So not only are we a mom's knife, like 8 damage ups wielding dead cat, but we're also going to be generating flies as we do it. I'd say it's pretty good. Okay. Excellent. I love it. Where are you at? There you are. Cool. No, I don't see a reason to do that. Let's just, are we going to do Hush? No, we're not going to do Hush. This run is long enough as it is. I don't need to bore everybody with a Hush fight. I don't really think that we're needing to get a whole lot on this run. Okay. No need to go to our cursed room either because it's just... we already are Guppy. So unless we want to pick up Cursed Eye and just kill our run. Okay. I'm going to fight this just because it could be something good. It ended up being absolutely nothing good and instead pretty useless stuff, so that's fine. But hey, we got a Spirit Heart out of it. Pop into these. More sacks. Shocker. I'd be fine with, like, an Emperor card. No? Don't want to give that to me? Alright. We'll carry the Lovers because it's honestly just a Spirit Heart waiting to happen. Why did I do the Big Room? Because I live life on the edge. Okay, I actually don't really want to fight this room, so let's just bomb our way out. Okay, that was fun. You're dead. And you're dead. Couldn't kill the bullet in time, but that's fine. No deal. We picked up a HP upgrade, which we will promptly get rid of right here. And then we'll pop the levers so that Dark Bum can give us another Spirit Heart. Good job. And then we just kind of, you know, run through, try and get to Mom. We ended up getting right back on track here with time because of the insanely good run we have. I didn't think that needed an explanation, but sure, it did. It dud? It did? It doesn't? It did dud? Don? You know what? Yeah, I don't really want to fight this floor not knowing where we're going. Okay. Just get over there. Good. And, you know, just kill Mom with her own knife. A little violent. Give me a way to get rid of this. Sure, a way to fly? Sounds great. I love it. We're going down. I almost forgot. Down sounds great. Satan should be a pretty quick fight, to be fair. The fact that we can fly kind of makes us unstoppable, because now we can dodge everywhere. We really just need to fire the knife once and then we're done. Secret room? No. I don't really want to even go for Spirit Hearts. Health is not a major concern of mine. Okay. Kill you two. Crack into these. Fate's Reward is going to fire really high damage shots, so that's good. Yeah. Big scythes that have Holy Light attached to them is pretty good. Excellent. We're going to be getting a ton of chests on the Dark Room, too, so that's something to look forward to. Okay. Satan, where you at, though? I'm looking for you. I got your number. Psych, that's the wrong number. Okay. The tick. That totally not worth it. I was going to say, like, eh, why not? But nah, it's honestly just not worth it. Good. I wish that there was like a Dark Bomb that picked up bombs and gave you this is a crawl space. So that's pretty good. We got a use out of it, and it is nothing I want. I don't even want to go pick that up. It's kind of useless. Kaylee's playing Undertale again. Apparently took a small break. Couldn't fight Undyne, who knows? Okay, I should be studying for tests right now. But, hey, who cares? Got anatomy, AP calc, and, a theology. Gotta learn about Shinto religion found in the Japanese regions. Love nature as its own. Okay. You're dead. You're dead. You're dead. And give me one more, you're dead. You're dead. Excellent. Oh, that worked well. Move on to the next floor. From here, we will go and fight the lamb, and then after that, we will fight Mega Satan. Because we, you know what, sure, Curse of the Tower. I love it. Sure, fire a bunch of bombs here. What do I care? I'm not soft. Sure, Odd Mushroom gives us just an insanely fast knife now. You know, bosses are kind of like the only thing that our run is good. Well, it's not the only thing our run is good for, but, like, it's really good just to use our knife on bosses, so these rooms are even easier. Okay, more items, sure. One step closer to spawn. These guys should drop a Spirit Heart. They did. More items. Sure, we'll take Best Bud. Excellent. You can keep giving me that room 10 times over. Just looking for our boss here. I'd love to be able to see our map. That would be great, but apparently that's too much to ask. We will go see what those two items are. I don't know why I'm talking like this. Another fly. One step closer to Beelzebub. This is the only time where I'm totally fine fighting this BS room, because we can basically kill it before it even damages us. Okay, this run went really out of control really quickly, and to be fair, I blame that entirely on the fact that we replayed that fifth floor. Kidney stone mom's knife. Does that even do anything? It would be sick if just every once in a while it threw out like 400 mom's knives. That would be the greatest synergy ever. Make it happen. Tyrone, you listening? Okay. Where the hell is our up again? Yeah, apparently. Ragman, you had a bad day. Cause Ragman had a bad day. Take it one down. Sing a pyramid. And Pharaoh around. Is that what he's supposed to be? Is he supposed to be like an old Pharaoh? Because it's got that feel to it. What the hell? What? Well, since when are there pots in here? Halo of Flies gives us Beelzebub. And sure, we'll take Eve's Mascara for even more freaking damage. I would love to completely demolish Mega Satan in like a minute and a half. Can we make that happen? That apparently revealed the secret room. Excellent. We also got Robo Baby, which is exactly what we needed to complete this run. He is just putting in the work. Okay. First boss is already dead. Eh, pretty much. Okay, good. That unlocked black lipstick, which is, I don't even remember what it does. So that's great. But let's head back and fight the old Mega Stan. I think the new boss in Afterbirth Plus and the new ending should be Mega Stain. Speaking of Stain, that was pretty good timing. But Mega Stain would make everything better. Okay. Down, right, up. Let's do this. Got two hearts. Really don't think that's going to be a problem. Okay, first wave already done. Second wave already done. Holy cow, that was sick. Yeah, this run's okay. I will provide the seed for you shortly, so if anybody would like to play along. It is 9BNCWFHV. You can check out this menagerie, which was fantastic. Okay, and we are done. So there you go. Eve post-it note complete. A weird run. Ended up being longer than it should have been with what we had, but it took some time to get there. If you enjoyed, leave a like, leave a comment, and subscribe, and I will see you all in the next episode. Goodbye!